Hello, this is Terrell Pauly with Learn Healthcare IT. In today's video, I wanted to discuss and kind of go over some of the different types of healthcare IT jobs that are available within the healthcare IT space in general. And I just wanted to kind of talk about some of the ones that are more typical that's from what I've seen based on my experience and being in this field in this space for 13 years, and just the different types of typical healthcare IT jobs and positions that I've seen along the way in my journey. So let's kind of get started. So first, number one, PACS Administrator. So a PACS Administrator is definition there, but a PACS administrator is someone that actually manages the overall, oversees the overall management of the PACS system. They actually are, they deal with managing, day-to-day issues as far as, and if you don't know what a PACS is or a PACS administrator, I'm giving you a definition, but if you don't know what a PACS is, I actually have courses, actually videos on my YouTube channel, more videos on my YouTube channel that you can actually take a look at that explains and go into more detail about what a PACS is. And most likely, I'll also probably go through maybe individually. I can maybe talk about each one of these types of jobs individually maybe, but I'm going to try to run through and not make it too long, I think. So, but a PACS administrator is someone that oversees the PACS. They are actually, they deal with day-to-day issues as far as image transfer issues, when you images that are not able to transfer, send it into PACS, maybe slow image transfer issues, display issues as far as images, quality issues as far as the images. And they also, do daily tasks as far as adding users, making user modifications into the actual PACS system. They are very pivotal type of employee in the radiology IT space. They're very, very important people. So that's pretty much overall, and they actually, depending on what type of PACS system that you have, they may be more hands-on as far as, they have to actually monitor and manage the actual hardware that the actual PACS system sits on itself, maybe, depending on the vendor. And they are actually had to oversee, make sure as far as the performance, the actual, make sure that the PACS system is running as it's supposed to be. It's not slow itself and it's not causing any issue. So that's what a PACS administrator does. And, I know per se myself because I was a PACS administrator for 4 years and I've worked with countless PACS admins within the field. So next, RIS administrator. So a RIS admin is somebody who manages the RIS system, which is RIS stands for Radiology Information System, and they oversee everything that deals with managing the RIS. It's kind of similar if you know anything about a system administrator, system admin, and the system administrator, they manage the overall system itself, active directory management, what have you, things of that nature. RIS administrator is kind of like the similar thing as far as, they manage everything that deals with the RIS system. Management of users, systems, the risk system itself, the performance, the workflows. So that's what a risk administrator does. And typically, in some facilities like hospitals and or image, well, depends on in smaller healthcare facilities like imaging centers, sometimes the RIS admin will also be the PACS administrator. So they kind of bundle those two together. So they'll be the RIS PACS administrator, and they kind of bundle those two into one role. Next, interface engineer. So interface engineer is someone that actually deals with the configures and management, manages like the HL7 integration between the different clinical information systems. So in this case, and for example, let me give you an example of that, right? So an example would be, like for instance, you have a RIS system and you have a PACS system. Now, if you have, let's say if you have two different types of vendors for that one uses a RIS system and another vendor for a PACS system, you have to be able to communicate data and information between the two systems. So typically how that's accomplished is through if you need to be able to send patient information, exam information, maybe like new orders, new visits, new orders, the actual reports, and other types of clinical information such as that. You're going to use HL7 to be able to do the communication in between the RIS and the PACS to be able to send that data. And this is where interface engineer comes into play, because the interface engineer needs to be able to configure and set up the actual workflow of how that data gets sent back and forth, and how it gets sent, how it gets received. You're going to have an HL7 engineer in that regard, and that's what they kind of handle. So that's interface, and they also troubleshoot any HL7 related issues, slow processing, failed HL7 messages, invalid messages. They kind of deal with all of that in regards to making sure that the HL7 integration between these different systems are operating correctly, smoothly, and efficiently as possible. Next, you can have an applications trainer. So an applications trainer can be any type of, they thoroughly train end users on how to use a clinical information system. Application trainer you have for any type of clinical information system that you have, like the PACS, the RIS, and EMR, which stands for electronic medical records, any sort of cardiology information system, any sort of clinical information system that you have, you can have an applications trainer that's trained and experienced in that system, and they'll be able to train the end users, on how to use the system. So you can be an application trainer for any type of clinical information system out there. And so that's number four. Number five is typically, you'll have IT, management wherever you go. You have IT management that'll just oversee and manages the different healthcare IT departments. Nothing new there, and that's pretty much standard project manager. Now, when you're dealing with implementations, as far as maybe you're installing a new clinical information system, maybe you're doing an upgrade, maybe you're doing a migration from one system to another, any sort of project that has significant changes that can occur with this project, we'll typically see an actual project manager that actually comes in and oversees the actual that actually comes in and oversees the actual management of the actual project. So, and they just kind of oversee it from beginning to end. You know, that's typically what a project manager does. Next, you have a implementation consultant. So implementation consultant, kind of, you know, they come in, they implement a project for a finite or maybe infinite amount of time. And, you know, they kind of come in for a task. They have a specific duty that's at play, you know, maybe, and they come in to support that task or that job role and that job function. It may be short, maybe, you know, like 6 months, 4 months, 6 months, or maybe extended. Perhaps it's longer than that, a year, 2 years, or maybe it's indefinite. And consultants can come in for, and they don't even have to be just implementation consultants. They can just be consultants in general. You know, you have consultants that come in and they assist, they can assist facilities, healthcare facilities that need some sort of help and or expertise in some areas that where they're maybe they're lacking, maybe they want to, they don't have maybe certain employees to perform certain tasks, or maybe they want to just be able to out, they don't have the bandwidth to where they can actually be able to perform the work with the current staff that they do have. So they'll seek outside resources to be able to assist. And typically, you know, like implementation consultant, you already have to have experience in, you know, you being a PAX admin, RIS administrator, interface engineer, applications trainer, something like that. You already have experience somewhere within the healthcare IT space. Now, one thing I want to kind of jump up to, if I can go back up to, is in addition to being the PAX administrator, you can also, depending on if the facility is that the healthcare facility is large enough, they can have to where it deems requires the PAX administrator can have staff that works under him, like a PAX analyst, that'll help with more of the day-to-day tasks will be kind of given to the PAX analyst, while the PAX administrator can kind of sit back and kind of oversee the PAX system from a more higher level. So, and then the same thing as a RIS administrator. A RIS administrator can also maybe have a RIS analyst that works under them, and it does the same thing, kind of handles more of the day-to-day duties. And the RIS, you know, the analyst positions are more geared towards more entry-level sort of positions. And with the larger healthcare facilities, you may even have maybe, so you have a PAX, RIS PAX administrator. You may have a RIS PAX analyst, more than one. And they may even have another tier of staff that are under the analyst, maybe an associate, or they may call them something else, maybe, I don't know, data entry. They'll have another term for it, that are actually under the analyst's position. And that's typically you'll see these sort of tiered levels, these sort of tiered job levels at larger healthcare facilities. Typically, when you're in the smaller healthcare facilities, like imaging centers, you will see the PACS administrator also being the RIS administrator. And they may also have other job roles. At the imaging center, you may be a RIS, PACS, PC technician, systems administrator. You may even dabble in networking too as well. So, you know, it all depends on what type of healthcare facility you're at and the size of the environment. So these are typically the usual types of different healthcare IT jobs in positions that I've seen in my experience working in this industry. These are more of the common ones. There's more out there, but based on what I've seen, these are more of the common ones that have been out there that I've run into and experienced and on a regular and common basis. So if you found this video to be helpful, you know, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments about any additional about this material here, you can actually just leave a comment in the comment section below. And I hope this was helpful. Till next time, my name is Terrell Pauly. Take care.